Hi, I'm Aurélien Bivot, and I'm presenting this joint work with Antoine Chambaz and Marc Vanderlaan, Generalized Policy Elimination, an Efficient Algorithm for Nonparametric Contextual Bandits. Contextual bandits are popular because they are widely applicable, in particular to recommender systems, ad placement, and personalized medicine. In this article, we work in the stochastic contextual bandit setting, which is a succession of the following steps. First, the environment draws a context following a certain distribution. Then the agent draws an action following a certain policy. And finally, the environment draws a reward conditional on the context and the action following a certain distribution of rewards conditional on context and actions. What people who implement contextual bandit algorithms in real life care about is to learn as fast as possible a policy that is going to deliver an expectation, a good return. The expected return of a policy at a one-time step is called the value of this policy. When you implement or you deploy a contextual bandit algorithm, it's important to consider over which policy class this algorithm operates, in which policy class it learns its policies. The value of the policy you've learned at a given time point, its distance to the best value you can achieve in the set of measurable policies can be decomposed in two terms. A bias term, which is the difference in value between the best measurable policy and the best policy in your class, and an instantaneous regret term, which is the difference in value between the best policy in your class and the policy you've learned at time t. The more complex your policy class, the smaller is going to be the bias, but the harder it is to learn the optimal policy in this class, so the higher is going to be the instantaneous regret. Here we're going to measure the complexity of a policy class by its metric entropy. The metric entropy at epsilon of a policy class pi is the number of balls of radius epsilon you need to cover this policy class. Parametric classes have metric entropy scaling as logarithm of 1 over epsilon, whereas nonparametric classes have entropy scaling polynomially in epsilon, which means scaling as epsilon minus p for p a positive real. How can you learn efficiently in a regret optimal fashion, or at least having good regret over a non-parametric policy class? One proposal is a variant of the policy elimination algorithm, which is an algorithm proposed by Miroslav Dudik and its co-authors in 2011. We generalize it in two directions. First, we make it implementable, as opposed to the initial proposal of Dudik, which is a theoretical non-implementable algorithm which relies on a non-implementable subroutine. And also, we make it applicable to non-parametric policy classes. The way it works is as follows. First, you start out with your entire policy class, and then you're going to successively eliminate out of it the policies you estimate to be suboptimal, thus generating a nested sequence of increasingly small policy classes that have increasingly better regret properties. The way we do it is first you initialize the first element in your sequence of policy to be as the entire policy class you wish to compete against. Then at each time steps, you do the following. First, you pick a good exploration policy, and I'm gonna get in a second to what I mean by a good exploration policy. Then you carry out a round under this exploration policy, which gives you an additional data point. Then what you do is you estimate for each policy in your current policy class an upper bound on its value, and you also estimate the value of the best policy in your current policy class, and you eliminate all of the policies that have upper bound on their value smaller than the estimated value of the best policy. As you can see, this algorithm requires to be able to estimate the value and an upper bound on the value for each policy in the current policy class. For the exploration step to be efficient, that is to take out many policies at a time and to eliminate faster, you need the upper bound not to be too high, which means you need the variance of your estimators of the value of policies in your class to be not too high. Is there an exploration policy that guarantees that you can estimate with little uncertainty the value of every policy in your class uniformly over your class? The answer is yes. There was a result proven by Dudik and its co-authors in 2011, of which a corollary is that for every policy class, there exists an exploration policy in this class, such that if you've collected t data points under this policy, then you can estimate the value of every policy in the class with variance less than a constant divided by t, and this is uniform over the policy class. It's quite a striking result. It's an existence result, but now the question is, how can you find such a policy? We show that if you have access to two optimization oracles, which I call linearly constrained optimization oracles, then the ellipsoid algorithm can help you find in polynomial time a good exploration policy. What I require is that you have access to linearly constrained least squares oracle, so a regular least squares oracle over your policy class subject to linear constraints on the policy, and a linearly constrained cost-sensitive classification oracle, so a regular cost-sensitive classification oracle subject to linear constraints. Our runtime result says that over t rounds, our algorithms makes no more than up to a constant t to the power of 3 log t calls to the optimization oracles. Why does this algorithm work? First, the elimination step guarantees that with high probability, you do not eliminate the actual best policy in the class, in the initial class. Second, it guarantees that after the elimination step, all of the remaining policies are going to be close to the actual best policy up to the width of the confidence interval. And this width getting smaller and smaller, your successive policy classes get better and better in regret. Since you pick an exploration policy in these policy classes, which are uniformly not too bad, well, you get better and better in terms of the policy you actually carry out, so you do not incur too much of a regret at each time step. This analysis can be made formal, and we proved a regret theorem, which claims that if the complexity of your policy class is no larger than epsilon to the power minus p, then for p smaller than 1, the cumulative regret is going to be no larger up to constant than square root of t, and for p greater than 1 is going to be no larger than t minus 1 over 2p. How does this compare with existing work? There is an existence result by Foster and Krishnamurthy, which we actually improve on by providing algorithms that have better regret in the entropy range 0 to 1 with exponent 0 to 1. Also, it's important to note that we are the first work to provide a regret optimal algorithm for integrable entropies. And for integrable entropies, we're doing as good as in the full information setting.